Hello, geeks and ghouls. Today we talk about this little book over here, The Cipher by Kathe Koja. The Cipher was first published in 1991 by Abyss, a Dell imprint of the more literary and weird horror, and was recently republished by Meercat Press. It's the second book I read by Kathe Koja. The other one was her second novel, Bad Brains. So I've read this book a couple of weeks ago, but I held my review because of I was in a bit of a loss of what I want to say, because I have mixed feeling about it, you see. And I have to say this first and foremost for everybody: I absolutely did not like the way Kathe Koja is writing, and this is not a Kathe Koja thing, this is a me thing. I think that her writing is very unique and very interesting and very good. It was not my thing. So if I'm not that blown away by this book, you know, this is because I subjectively did not like it. Objectively though, I think it's a very interesting book that many of you will love. And speaking of Kathe Koja's writing, I think that she has a very evocative, very unique writing style. She uses a lot of small sentences or fragments of sentences, and they're strung together in some very long periods, so it feels like a stream of consciousness. It feels like a cornucopia of details and actions and thoughts and emotions and descriptions tied together in a very interesting way. It feels like you watch every scene reflected on fragments of a broken mirror of sorts. And I know that some of you will love this writing style. It's very soft, it's very evocative, it's very focused on the details, on the minor details, the thoughts, the emotions that are tied together. And the experience of reading her books is definitely something that is quite unique and interesting. It's just not my thing. And it's the second book I read, and I dislike the writing in both books in the same way. On Cipher, however, I really liked the premise and her brand of horror. The Cipher is about two failed artists in Chicago in the early 90s, Nicholas and Dakota, and they are sort of fascinated with holes. Different kind of holes, different kind of fun holes. Dakota, she's a bartender, she hangs around in avant-garde exhibitions, and she's fascinated with a black hole that she and Nicholas, her on-and-off boyfriend, found in a storage space next to his apartment. And Nicholas, the narrator of this book, is a simple guy. He is fascinated with Dakota and her fun holes, as many young men do with the fun holes of young women. And the fun hole is definitely an interesting find. It's definitely an interesting premise for a novel. And what made me read this novel, I really love how Kathe Koja is mixing cosmic horror, existential horror, psychological horror, and body horror into one, and it kind of feels, you know, her own brand. See, here one of her usual themes is artistic expression and torment artists, and how this torment manifests in supernatural ways. She did the same thing for Bad Brains, and she does the same thing in The Cipher. The book starts with Nicholas and Dakota playing around the fun hole. They have discovered it and doing experiments with it. They put a bottle of insects inside, and the insects come out altered. They are molten together, or they have two heads, and they start dying. So, you know, you don't have to mess with the hole. And Dakota is fascinated by it, and Nicholas is terrified, but he plays along because this allows him to, you know, get into Nakota's pants. And the relationship between these two is really fascinating, because it's definitely a toxic relationship, a relationship that is not good for anybody. Nakota kind of hates Nicholas, but he is her ticket to the fun hole. And Nicholas hates Dakota, but also hates himself for lusting after her and slaving for her. And the way Dakota is described is definitely not a cat. And after they put the insects in the fun hole, they put a camera and film what's inside. And Dakota is fascinated by the tape. Nicholas doesn't quite get it. And then Dakota tries to put her head inside the hole, and Nicholas tries to stop her. They fight, and in the fight, Nicholas ends up putting his hand inside the hole. And when it comes out, things are different, because there is a swell in his hand and some strange things are happening with it. He has some weird sensations, some visions and ideas and abilities he didn't have before. And not only is his life falling apart and his sanity deteriorating, a bunch of Lakota's artist friends also discover the hole and they gather around it, and they form some sort of a cult around the hole. And along with this cult comes a struggle for dominance between different gurus inside this group, and that's one of the interesting aspects of the book that was not quite fully explored, mostly because everything is told through Nicholas's point of view, and at this point Nicholas has lost touch with a lot of what's happening around him. The people orbiting around the hole are just, you know, just coming in and out of his consciousness, so we don't see a lot about the dynamics around the hole, but it was definitely interesting, something I wasn't exactly expecting from the premise of the book, and not as explored as I would like it, but that's a thing about me reading this book. I love the ideas it had, but not how they were implemented. As I said again, it was a me thing. Not liking this book as much as I did, and the whole not only changes Nicholas and Irotsky's sanity, it is also affecting everybody that's coming in contact with it. Their sanity and their relationships deteriorate. It's as if this fun hole, the black hole, is sucking in everything positive and rational about the people who come in contact with it. And I don't want to spoil anything else, but the ending really hit me hard. If you're wondering, okay, is there an explanation for what is happening? I really want to read a book that what I read is explained. There may be some sort of an explanation about the fun hole and its nature, but not exactly. But what is explained about it really won me over. I really liked the ending and the way it is given to us, what is presented in here. Made me want to go and reread this book sometime in the future, because it explains everything, it vibes with me, and I believe that going back now, the writing will make a lot of sense. The way this book is written fits what it's trying to convey, and while I did not quite enjoy it, I respect it. I believe it's a very interesting book, and you should definitely give it a shot, especially if you're into the weirder, more experimental horror. If you've read this book, I'd love to hear your opinions about it in the comments below. And as always, like, subscribe, and I'll see you soon. Thank you for watching, and stay spooky!